We'll look at problems. So this is more problems on series. So the question here is, given summation an, an's are positive. Okay, so we have not yet started with negative ones. Decide if summation an converges or not. Okay, so that's the problem. So what do we know? How many tools we have for this? Okay, so what do we know? So far. Okay, so first we know that nth term test, if limit a n as n goes to infinity is not zero, then summation a n diverges. Okay, so this is the first thing we check. If limit a n exists and zero, then we don't do anything. We just continue. If it is different than zero, then we write it down. And that's the conclusion. The series diverges. And what else do we have? We have the integral test. The integral test, generally, if the series is too complicated, this is what we try. So if f of x on, say, some 1 to infinity is is positive, continuous, decreasing. Okay, so it's a lot of words here, but such things we immediately notice when we see the function. And f of n is equal to a n for all large integers. Okay. Then summation a n converges if and only if integral from 1 to infinity f of x dx converges. Okay, so if and only if means that if this if this integral diverges, then our series also diverges. Okay, so what else did we learn? Comparison test. Okay, so then we learned comparison test, direct comparison test. So this says that if you have this for all large n, for all large n. So all these things for all large n means that you have an infinite you have an infinite sum. Of course, the first 1 million terms is a finite sum. After a while, you start detecting a pattern. Okay, so we are always saying that if a certain pattern holds, then this relation, this result holds. Okay, so if there is this pattern for all large n, then if, so let's do it two parts. If summation bn converges, then summation an converges. And if if summation an diverges, then summation bn also diverges. Okay, so again, it takes a lot of words to write this, But if the large one converges, then it forces the small one to converge. If the small one goes to infinity, the larger one will also go to infinity. That's the main thing. And we have, okay, I'll call it 3 prime limit comparison test. So sometimes it's not easy to see this. We have to go very far away for very very large n to see that something like this holds with the constant here. So that's the limit comparison test to see that actually one of them will be larger than the other. Eventually, we take the limit. Okay, so we take the limit of limit n goes to infinity of a n over b n be equal to L. Okay, so here L is a number. Since these are positive, L cannot be negative, but it can be zero. L can be zero, and it can also be infinite in our case. So if this limit does not exist, except the case when L is infinite, we don't apply this. Okay, you should be able to calculate this limit, and either the limit is zero, infinite, or it is some real number. Then, okay, so the reason I called this 3 prime is because you make your conclusions here always by looking at this thing. Now, first, C is, in this case I called it L. L is a non-zero finite number, okay? Then it means that this is what you should go through your mind. A n over b n is in some neighborhood of L, okay? So there is a space on both sides of L between between 0 and L there is a space, and between L and infinity there is a space. So a n over b n is between L minus epsilon and L plus epsilon. So this is larger than L minus epsilon, smaller than L plus epsilon. So you take b n to the other side. A n is less than a constant times b n, and also a n is larger than a constant times b n. Okay, so this allows you to do that. Okay, so the picture is something like this. This is L. This is zero. This is L minus epsilon, L plus epsilon. Since L is different than zero, I can find an epsilon so that L minus epsilon is still positive. Okay, so that will not be the case in the next case when L is equal to zero. Okay, so in this part, a n over b n is here for large n. Okay, so then you can take it to the previous part. If you say that a n is less than b l, this constant times b n, if b n converges, it forces a n to converge. And on the other side, a n will be larger than a positive constant times b n. So if bn goes, summation of bn's go to infinity, summation of an's will go to infinity. So this is what you should go through your mind immediately. And in this case, we have summation an converges if and only if summation bn converges. So this is the easiest part. In the second part, L is equal to zero. Okay, so in this picture, we have only this part. This is zero. This is epsilon. So epsilon is L plus epsilon. This is L. Okay, so a n over b n is here for all large n. Okay, so here you see that I can only say that a n is less than epsilon times b n. Here you can take epsilon as 1. Generally, that's what goes through your mind. If this limit is 0, then this this ratio is less than 1 from some point on. So an is less than bn. Okay. In this case, if summation bn converges, then summation an converges. Okay, so that's the only thing that you can say. If summation bn diverges, it doesn't impose any condition on an because there is no chance that it is smaller than an. Okay, so here, of course, you can also say if summation an diverges, then summation bn diverges, but that's not a new information because normally we are interested in summation an. You always write summation an on top and the series whose divergence or convergence you know on the bottom. So that's generally a habit. So we are only interested in what information we can derive about an once we know bn. Okay, so here only if bn converges, I can say this. If bn diverges, I don't know anything. And now the whole idea is the same when L is equal to infinity. Now in this case, take any number here. Okay, let's say this is zero. Take any epsilon. Epsilon can be a million or whatever. In practice, take epsilon equals one. Okay, then an over bn is here for all large n. Okay, so here you see that an is large. Since this is going to infinity, an is large. Then if summation bn diverges, then summation an also diverges. So so this is how limit comparison works, and you see that this is the key part. Actually, you have the direct comparison thing, but sometimes direct comparison starts far away from 1. So the tail of the, there is a comparison for the tails of the series, and sometimes a constant is involved. So an is not directly less than bn, but an is less than a constant time bn. So it is this constant here, okay, or this constant, depending on which way you are comparing them. So this is what limit comparison does for us. And of course, this brings us the question, how do I find bn's? For bn's, we don't have many things. We have only two things for bn. Okay. So what to use for bn? Summation bn. Surprisingly, we don't have much. We only have a few things so far. So one part is the p series. Summation 1 over n to the p, n equals from 1 to infinity, converges if and only if p is strictly larger than 1. Otherwise, it diverges. Okay, so this is the one thing we know. And the second thing is geometric series. Okay, so summation rn, n equals 0 to infinity, converges, we even know the sum, if and only if absolute value of r is less than 1. Okay, so in our case, until we come to series with negative terms, here r will be positive. So this converges if and only if r is strictly less than 1. Okay, so these are the only things we know. We don't need to panic. We don't have an infinite collection of information. This is all we know. Okay, so we'll try to handle problems with these things. And then we'll try to find other techniques later on. So the techniques that we are missing is what happens when some of the terms in summation an, if some of them are negative. Okay, so here we'll do it next hour. We only know what to do if the terms, if the signs are alternating. You have 1 plus, 1 minus, 1 plus, 1 minus. That's the only case where you know whether it converges or not. Otherwise, you have to consider all absolute values. Look at the series with the absolute values. If it converges, then the term with negatives here and there will converge. If the terms with absolute values, if that series does not converge, then we don't know anything. Okay, so we are not yet in a position to understand all of the secrets of the universe. And then using this, we will using this comparison test in a tricky way, and comparing with geometric series, we'll find the ratio test. Okay, so the ratio test will probably be the most popular test because it's very easy to apply. You see, in these tests, in the integral test, you have to integrate. Okay, so that's a lot of work. If this comparison test, you must know some bn. With the ratio test, you just take an, play with an. You don't need to know any bn. Then, if you are lucky, you'll find out whether it converges or not. Okay, so we'll take a certain limit there, an plus 1 over an. If that limit is different than 1, then we know something. If that limit is 1, then again we don't know anything. Okay, so I'm saying these things so that you don't feel responsible that these things, all these series can be understood, but you fail to understand them. Not all series can be understood, but there are certain series which show up in science and engineering. So all these techniques are aimed to understand those ones, and the others we don't know. Okay, so with that said, let us start with some problems. Now, if you keep these in mind, you'll realize that the problems are easy. Okay, because the problems must be such that we can solve them with only these 2.5 techniques. Okay, so let me start with one of them, for example. Okay, so now problems. So one of them is summation n plus 2 over n square root n. Okay, so what is your first gut feeling? So does the general term go to zero? Okay, so then we pass that. So what should we do now to decide whether it converges or not? Well, we know don't go to integral test. Okay, integral test is always the last thing you try because integration requires creativity. We want to use our brain only when we have to. So let us do it with as little intelligence as possible. So when, for example, when n is large, that plus 2 here, okay, that was irrelevant. So in your mind, when nobody is looking, you can omit 2 there. We are just trying to understand the behavior. Then, of course, in our calculations, we'll have that plus 2 there. So when n is very large, I don't care about 2. So this is about like n over n plus n times square root 2. N's will cancel. I'll have 1 over square root n. Does it converge? No, because of p-test, right? Because of this one. Okay, so this thing, when n is very large, this behaves like this one. 1 over n to the power 1 over 2, it diverges. Okay, so now I have to either show that this is larger than 1 over n to the power 1 over 2, or the easiest thing in such things is to use the limit comparison test. Okay, because with the comparison, you have to do it term by term, but the limit comparison says that eventually it will be larger than a constant times something, and nobody cares what the constant is. So limit comparison in these cases is easier. Okay, so my first reaction was, I looked at this, there are more n's here than here, so this goes to zero. Okay, so n term test doesn't apply. This still has a chance of converging or diverging. When n is very large, I in my mind omitted this 2, then this n's canceled. I realized that this behaves like 1 over square root n. Okay, so here now I say as if certain, I don't mention this to anybody. Okay, so in the solution, out of the blue, I say limit compare with summation 1 over square root n. Okay, which diverges, maybe I should remind myself. Okay, so I have n plus 2 over n square root n. This is my a n, and 1 over square root n. Okay, I simplify this. This is n plus 2 over n. I take the limit as n goes to infinity. Okay, so that's one thing that you should not forget. With this, with limit comparison, since the name is limit, we don't generally forget to take the limit of this. But on Thursday when we do ratio test, in ratio test you take one term divided by the other term, take the limit. If the limit is less than one, we will be able to say something. But then in the name of this is ratio test. Okay, so you take the ratio, and if you are in a hurry, you forget to take the limit. You say if the ratio is less than one, you make some conclusions, which is not always correct because you have to take the limit. Okay, so now here we take the limit. This goes to 1 as n goes to infinity. Okay, so it is this case. This says our series does whatever the other series does. This series diverges. Okay, so hence by limit comparison test, our series diverges. Okay. Okay, now let's look at the other ones. Okay, so this is summation n equals 1 to infinity, 5 to the n, 7 to the n plus 3, 2, 1, 0. Okay, so what do you say? Limit comparison.
5 over
5 to the power n over 7 to the power. Okay, so let's do that. So again, what goes through our mind is that when n is very large, these are going to be large numbers. They'll compete with each other. Nobody will ask this guy's opinion, so it's not there. So this behaves like a geometric series. The general term is less than 1. It converges. So let us limit compare this. Use limit comparison with the geometric series summation 5 over 7 n, which converges. Since, okay, so we don't have to write this, but we are reminding this to ourselves, since this is less than 1. If you write such things in your, not necessarily for the exam, but in your actual calculation notebooks, if you put such details which look totally obvious to you, you'll be surprised how useful they will be next week. Next week you check your calculations. If this wasn't here, you would spend half an hour trying to find out why you wrote it. Okay, so these things do happen. Trust an old man. I lived these things for... But anyway, other old men told me to do this. I didn't do this, so you will learn it with your own experience. Okay, so let's look at this. 5n over 7n plus 3, 2, 1, 0. This is my an. Divide by 5, 7n. Okay, so this is going to be 5n over 7n plus 3, 2, 1, 0, 7n over 5n. Okay, so this looks like this goes to what? 1, right? This goes to 1. This goes to 1 as n goes to infinity. So our series converges by limit comparison test. But I think in this case, a direct comparison will also work, because the general term here is strictly less than the other general term, right? Okay, so another thing. So let's say also note 5 to the n over 7n plus 3210 is strictly less than 5n over Sn. Okay, so our series converges by direct comparison test. Okay, so in these problems there is no better solution. If you apply one test and you find out that it converges, that's a good solution. Okay, so don't try to find a more elegant solution. We are not after that in such problems. Okay, so other thing I had is, okay, so every time there is an arctangent in the series, it confuses and scares people. So let us have one example with an arctangent in it. 3. I have arctangent n over n to the power 3 over 2. Okay, so arctangent is scary, but what is it doing? As n goes, how does arctangent n behave as m becomes larger and larger? It goes to pi over 2, so that means this guy is an innocent guy. It looks horrible. He is ugly, but he is a very nice person. It doesn't go to infinity, doesn't do anything. So arctangent n goes to pi over 2. Pi over 2 is less than 2. Okay, so arctangent is less than 2. Instead of arctangent, I could have 2 there. 2 over n to the power 3 over 2 diverges, converges. P test converges larger than 1. 3 over 2 is larger than 1. It converges. Okay, so that's the solution then. Okay, note arctangent n, well, this is positive because we start with n equals 1. And less than pi over 2, it will be pi over 2 in the limit. So it is strictly less than pi over 2. And this pi over 2 is 3 over 2. Well, it's strictly less than 2. Okay. So arctangent n over n to the power 3 over 2 is positive. Okay. So it is it is in our domain of techniques. So this is less than 2 over n 3 over 2. This is 3 over 2. And this summation 2 over n 3 over 2 converges by p test. Okay, so 3 over 2 is larger than 1. To remind ourselves where we looked at this. Okay, so our series converges by direct comparison. You can also, of course, if you are scared here, then you won't see this. But you will say that this is the key element here. Maybe let me first try limit compare this with this one. Okay, then when you do that, then you will realize that the limit is pi over 2. When the limit is pi over 2, then they both converge or diverge together. This converges, so this converges. That also works. Okay, so I think so this one is like that one. So let me skip. Well, okay, let's do that. We are trying to have fun. m plus 3 over n over m plus 4 to the n. Okay, so the only thing that's different there is there we had 3,000 something. So when n is very large, nobody pays any attention to 3,000 something. But here, when n is large. So we have to consider that. Okay, but this is exponential. Exponential is always larger than polynomial. So when n is large, this n will be negligible compared to this one. It will not be small, but it will be negligible compared to this one. So when n is large, this will behave like this. We didn't prove anything. We are just speculating. What I say may be wrong, okay? But we are trying to get an idea, an impression. Then we will make a guess, and we'll try to prove that guess. If we cannot prove that guess, then either we failed to apply the test properly, or our guess was wrong. But first, you should, without any inhibition, you must speculate. Okay, so here we speculate that when n is very large, this will behave like this, and this is a geometric series. So, okay, let me not mention how I reached to that conclusion to anyone, but let me just out of the blue compare this with the this geometric series. Okay. Limit compare with summation 3 over 4 n equals 1 to infinity, which converges. Okay, so the general term is less than 1. Okay, let's see how that goes. This is my a n, and 3 over 4 n is my bn. Okay, so this is m plus 3n, 4n over m plus 4n, 3n. Okay, so clearly this goes to 1, right? Any problem with that? This goes to 1. Okay, so you see that this is 12 to the power n. So let's take 12 to the power n out. Then here you have 12 to the power n. When n goes to infinity, this will be 0. Here again, take 12 to the power n out, n over 12n plus 1. Okay, so here apply L'Hopital in one step. Okay. Apply L'Hopital in one step. Use L'Hopital. Limit of this is 0 as n goes to infinity. Okay. You take the limit of this, it disappears. You take the limit of this, you still have that times logarithm ln 12. Okay, so in the next step, it goes to 0. Okay, so then these cancel, and you have just 1. So the limit of this is 1 as n goes to infinity. So our intuition here was correct. This converges. So our series converges by limit comparison test. Okay? Any questions? When somebody else solves these things, they all look easy. So here, the only difficult part is by looking at this thing and speculating. Okay? It is difficult because you are scared to make mistakes. Okay? We are all conditioned about making mistakes. Don't make mistake, don't make mistake. That's wrong. Okay? So probably the most important lesson you should learn at university is that you should make mistakes. Okay, you can't learn anything if you don't make mistakes. This sounds very paradoxical, but if you graduate with only learning this by heart, then your future is bright. Okay, all the other technicalities they are in the books. When you need them, you can read them. But the attitude is not in the books. You should learn the attitude. Okay. Look at this, speculate, and conclude that it diverges. Okay? Why does it diverge? Because you compare it with something. Try it. Okay, while you are trying it, then you learn something. Okay, then you see that okay, this guy behaves different than the guy you are comparing with it. Okay, then you go back and correct it. Okay. Okay, so next one. Okay, so this one, these things these things will be able to do much easily when we learn limit ratio tests, but we can even do it now. Okay, so when you have n factorial, the best thing to do is to use the ratio test, which we will do on Thursday. But here, when you have n factorial, at least you know you won't try integral test. Okay, so you should try the nth term test or comparison. As I said, it is if it is difficult to check the nth term test, you bypass it. Okay, so the only thing we are doing the nth term test is not to be embarrassed. If it is very easy to see that the general term does not go to zero, then we don't want to waste our time with complicated other tests to find the result. But here, okay, no one can immediately see what happens here. The general term probably goes to zero because n to the power n means you keep multiplying n by itself, but on the top n factorial, you start from 1, 2, 3, and only the last term is n. So probably general term goes to zero. Let's skip it. Okay, so I want to compare this with something. Again, since I have factorial, I will not do integration. So the only test I know is comparison. Either I'll limit compare or or direct compare. Okay. So what do you do? Okay, you start playing with the critical, crucial term is play with the play. You have to play with these things. Mathematics is a game. Okay, so we try to sell it as a science so that Abdullah Atalar will pay us money, but it's a game. Okay, so you play. You take the general term, you play with it. So let's see what the general term looks like. Okay, so an is n factorial over n to the n. Okay, so these are shorthands for something. What is it shorthand for? This is 1, 2, 3, n. Okay, so n minus 1, n. Okay, I'm totally satisfied. This is n factorial. But what does this guy do? This is n, 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 n. Okay, so I start getting a feeling that the denominator will grow very rapidly so that in the summation, it will pull the sum to a finite value. But now, how can I convince myself that it will be the case? At this point, for example, I can also suspect that this diverges, maybe. Okay, so I looked at this, and I said that this diverges, it behaves like 1 over n. Okay, so let us try to see if it is smaller or larger than 1 over n. Remember, we don't have any other technique to apply it to this one at this point. We have to apply only comparison or limit comparison. Okay, and comparison is easier because you don't take any limits. If you can't find something to compare with, then you go to limit comparison. So the simplest thing is comparison. Let us start with comparison. So we first suspect that this summation of these things diverges and it behaves like 1 over n. So is this thing larger than 1 over n? Because we know that summation 1 over n diverges. If the general term of this is larger than 1 over n, then that will force this to diverge. Okay, let's try to show that this is larger than 1 over n. Is it larger than, smaller than 1 over n? Our guess is now it is larger than 1 over n. An is larger than 1 over n. Hmm? Somebody is shaking his head, so let's take his idea. What is your idea? Less than what? Okay, so your idea is that this part, I can cancel this. This part is strictly less than 1. Each of them is strictly less than 1. So this is strictly less than 1 over n. Summation 1 over n diverges. So imposes no condition, no restriction on summation an. Okay, so this didn't tell us anything, but at this we learned something. We learned that these terms, we recognize that these terms are less than 1. So what do we do now? What can we do? Let's do it with 1 over n squared, because we already have a cheap inequality here. Okay, so if our first guess was wrong, but while we are trying to push our first guess, we obtained a cheap inequality here, and it didn't help us because this guy was diverging, summation of this. If summation of these things were convergent, it would immediately give us the result. So we look at here, instead of putting the parentheses here, if I put the parentheses here, I'll have 2 over n squared. Okay, next try this, an is equal to 1, 2, 3, n minus 1, n over n. So these cancel. I put the parentheses here this time. So this is strictly less than 2 over n squared. Okay, now I'm done. Okay, so because now I know that this converges, summation 2 over n squared converges by p test. So summation an converges by direct comparison. Okay, so this is a very typical way of approaching a problem. It doesn't matter whether your first guess is correct or wrong. Okay, so you see, while we were trying to play with this, we observed something. Now with that extra information, we go back and change our guess. Now we hope that this is going to converge, and it works. Okay. okay. So the next one is interesting, because we see that with the p test, summation 1 over n to the p converges when p is larger than 1, and p can be very, very close to 1. 1 plus epsilon, choose any small epsilon, positive, 1 plus epsilon, 1 over n to the power 1 plus epsilon will converge. Okay, so how much more can we make this dangerous? Okay, so that's the next one is that. 6, summation n equals 1 to infinity, 1 over n to the power 1 plus 1 over n. Okay, 1 plus 1 over n is always larger than 1, but it becomes smaller and smaller. 1 plus 1 over n as a power is always less than 1 plus epsilon eventually, no matter which epsilon you choose. Okay, so this will always be larger. The power will always be larger than 1, but it's approaching 1. Now it's dangerous. Okay, so is it going to converge or diverge? Let's compare it 1 over n. Okay, so at this point we didn't have any guess, but apparently, since this 1 over n is negligible after a while, this may behave like 1 over n. Okay, so we are just checking now. So try limit comparison. We have summation 1 over n, which diverges. This is the harmonic series, remember. So my term is n 1 plus 1 over n, this is a n divided by 1 over n. So now I try with this, I have n here, n 1 plus 1 over n. Okay, so to make this obvious, let me write it like this. This is n times n to the power 1 over n. I cancel these, then the limit of this is what? These are limits that occur very frequently, and it's also listed on Moodle as useful limits, limit of n to the power 1 over n.
It's 1.
1. Yes, that's, you have to look it up. This goes to 1 as n goes to infinity. Okay, so limit n goes to infinity, n to the power 1 over n is 1. Okay, so this is, you either memorize this, or you think like as follows, exponential is always dominant, okay? Here is your exponential, your exponent is going to zero, so eventually everybody will obey that. Something to the power zero is one, okay? So this is not mathematical, but this is how you apply general rules. General tendency with these numbers is that exponentiation, exponents always win over polynomials, polynomials win over logarithms. So when you do that, the limit should be 1, and then you remember that this was also 1. How do you prove these things? These are not magical. Take logarithm of this. You have ln over n. Well, as n goes to infinity, it goes to 0. So it means that this ln of this is going to 0. So it is going to 1. Okay, so these things are not magical. Okay, now, apparently this works by limit comparison test, hence by limit comparison test our series diverges. Okay, so you cannot make this power become closer and closer to one. It must stop at some point, and then it will sum up to a finite number. But if you allow it to approach to 1, then it will be divergent. It will go to infinity. Okay, let's take a break. Next hour, we'll look at alternating series.